Hi, I'm Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and I'm here to tell you what's out at the movies. This is a dramatic day because we're beginning the fall season. Last week we just really talked about wrapping things up and previewing the fall, but these are the real fall movies. And the first one I'm going to mention is a real crackerjack good one. It's called The Informant with an exclamation point. It's directed by Steven Soderbergh, starring Matt Damon. Matt Damon porked up about 30 pounds, eating all kinds of bad junk food, and is wearing a rug, and he's wearing glasses, and he's like nothing you've ever seen him before in. And it's all to the good, because this is a true story. It's one of those famous Hollywood true stories. This guy named Mark Whitaker, back in the 90s, he's basically working at an agribusiness, and the FBI starts to wiretap him to see that the company is doing things with corn additives or something that's suspicious. He decides that he'll wear a wire for the FBI and become something out of a James Bond movie. He just gets into it. And since I didn't read this book by Ken Eichenwald, I didn't know this story. I remember it vaguely from the headlines. The great thing that Soderbergh does here is he plays this as some gigantic dysfunctional farce. This is not like The Insider, where you just go docudrama and tell the truth. It's got this crazy score by Marvin Hamlisch and a voiceover by Matt Damon, where we see how bugfoot nuts he is. He is psycho. And as the movie goes on, we begin to see that, you know, he's wearing the wire for the FBI, he's been stealing from the company himself. He is nuts. Now, a lot of critics have said, well, I would rather that you told the story straight. You know what this critic says? I would rather not. I think this was an interesting way to get at the world we live in now, the world where we have Bernie Madoffs, where we have the Elliot Spitzers, where it's political, it's economic, and it's without shame. We've forgotten to be ashamed. We live in fantasy worlds and just say it's all right because the fantasy is better than the reality we live. This is a smart movie, a funny movie, and some of the best work Soderbergh has done. It's a caper that's more interesting than all three Ocean's movies combined, and Matt Damon is doing something really unique and special as an actor. So, boom. But I don't think that The Informant's going to be the number one movie. The number one movie is going to be a film called Jennifer's Body. This is the movie that stars Megan Fox and Amanda Seyfried, and it's written by Diablo Cody, who has called this basically hell. Hell is a teenage girl, and she should know. I mean, she won the Oscar for writing Juno, but this is a movie about a high school in a place that just seems like everyday America. And Megan Fox is, of course, the high school beauty queen, the one that's huge about everything. Everybody just looks at that beauty and loves her, who gets sacrificed to Satan. Satan is somebody that needs virgin sacrifices. The mistake was that Megan's character, Jennifer, is not a virgin. In fact, as she says in one of Diablo Cody's lines, I'm not even a backdoor virgin. This is a movie where we're watching somebody turned, sold to Satan, by whom? By Adam Brody and his indie rock band, who says as the excuse, do you know how hard it is for an indie rock band to make a name for themselves in this? Yeah, we know here at Rolling Stone, we definitely know. Funny and horror are supposed to be the most difficult thing to mix. I've heard people trash and ranking out this movie because, well, don't we need to see this again? It is a different kind of a movie. It is different because it is written, directed, and starring women. The women get to be it. This is no Friday the 13th night, Nightmare at Elm Street kind of thing. The women are the monsters. They get the revenge on the men. And this is the first time that I've seen Megan Fox comedic. I mean, come on, you all know what I think about both Transformers movies. Horrible. They were horrible. They give no one a chance to act. In fact, Megan Fox herself has said, Michael Bay wants me to scream and run and take my clothes off. That basically is what I do. I talked to Megan Fox recently for my ABC show, Popcorn, and I asked her about this movie and what scene in this movie was special for her, that it satisfied her and her need to become an actress or something more than just the face on covers of magazines, like Rolling Stone, in fact, where she is on the cover. Is there a moment in that movie that sticks with you,
oh,
in which you say to yourself, that comes close to what I wanted to put up on that screen?
That's a lovely question. I was expecting something totally different.
See, I'm just not this
You're
person.
A lovely
My
man.
Goodness. tie. Wow.
I like that you're not wearing a tie also.
I'm not doing
you're
it.
You're snazzy today.
Yeah.
I think there's a moment just that was very real for me, and that's been very real for a lot of women or girls at one point or another in their life, where Jennifer is, she's already, she's not a zombie, but whatever we're going to call her. I call her a succubus. I'm not sure what she is, but she's undead, basically, dying. And she's getting ready for prom, and it's a really short scene with no dialogue where she's sitting in front of the mirror trying to cover up the damage, like, what's happened to her, and trying to restore herself to how she was before. And that was just a very real moment for me as a girl, having that, trying to put on the mask, trying to hide all of your emotional and physical imperfections.
Okay, we've seen Megan Fox say this. I just want to go out on Jennifer's body and say this. Director, woman, Karin Kusama. Writer, Diablo Cody. Amanda Seyfried, who you remember from Mamma Mia and Mean Girls, and Megan Fox getting together to talk about women being empowered. The idea that this is a movie like a Trojan horse. It's put into the multiplex as if it were the typical Hollywood movie that guys can go see, Megan Fox take her clothes off, and when they get their big surprise, it's going to be revenge on us guys. Okay, bitch about it. Say that you really can't take it, but this is a horror movie that's got a mind and a heart, so for all its flaws, I'm really rooting for it. A flaw doesn't matter when there's some energy and some thinking behind it, and Jennifer's body has that. All right, it's scum bucket time. Yes, it's scum bucket time, and that means that since I spent the last week talking about fall previews, things came out, bad movies came out, people, that thought they escaped the scum bucket because I didn't do one and I was fall previewing. You don't get away from the scum bucket. You just don't. Not in this world and not on this show. And so, of course, I have to have cards because there's so many of them. Gamer. Did you see that one? Did you really see Gamer, which came up with the wonderful idea that we are just in humanity being controlled as some gigantic video game? Wasn't that in The Matrix? Wasn't that in The Matrix 2 and The Matrix 3? I think so. Bomb. Hated Gamer. Sorority Row, when I talk to you about Jennifer's body at least having some kind of intelligence behind it, here is that kind of horror movie that has no intelligence to it whatsoever. Sorority girls involved in a crime and they're haunted by it. And does the ghost come back to get them? Does the monster come back to get them? I Know What You Did Last Summer. Do we remember that? Do we remember the countless sequels and ripoffs? The same thing. I'm sorry, people. Scum bucket. Bomb. Horrible. The next one, Whiteout. Whiteout. Kate Beckinsale, you know, who has real talent and who keeps doing things like this. Here she's in Antarctica, and there's murder, and it's cold, and yet Kate Beckinsale still gets to open this movie taking a shower. Low formula, scummy crap. Horrible. Whiteout. Ah, bomb. And last but not least, we now have the movie Love Happens, starring Jennifer Aniston in her umpteenth romantic comedy with that note of sadness to it, because in this one, she and Aaron Eckhart meet. They're bruised by life, but they're saying, you know what, people? Love happens. Are you effing kidding me? Scum bucket. So listen, you people out there, I am saying in my usual damn you Hollywood way, you think you're going to sneak these movies out on me? No way. We got the bucket, we're going to stick with it, and we are going to nail you fuckers. I'm Peter Travers.